Tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, John Richardson, Lee Mack, Catherine Ryan, Joe Wilkinson, the Brett Domino Trio, Susie Bitts, Rachel Riley, and your host, Jimmy
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up is team captain John Richardson. John Richardson, he's the answer to the question, what would it look like if a pair of beige socks came to life and started talking about steam trains? joining John tonight, he looks like the type of guy who buys his toothbrushes second-hand. It's Joe Wilkinson! Up against them this evening, it's guest team captain Lee Max here.
Thank you for that, guys.
Lee recently appeared in the BBC sitcom Semi-Detached, where he played a man having a midlife crisis. I haven't seen it, but I imagine he gets his teeth whitened and has a hair transplant.
They like it when it's about you, don't they? I've noticed that. Is that what it is? Because I haven't seen you for a while. Is that what that is, a transplant?
The front bit's a transplant. It was...
There's a lot more of it now than when I last saw it, and I was worried that I was actually watching an old repeat.
Do they take the hair from somewhere else?
They do take the hair from somewhere else.
Where?
The back of your head. Where were you thinking?
Arse.
I'm having a similar problem at the...
Can we have a look at the? Can we have a look at that?
That's nice.
I'd never noticed that.
It's because I'm so tall. You can't usually see that.
Because you're sitting down, we don't notice.
No.
6'2", yeah.
Is it been rubbing on the bottom of tables?
I was having my hair cut, and I said, I'm a bit worried I'm going bald. And my barber said, well, you know, there's a place does it up here, just outside Skipton. And I just thought, I'm not going to go there.
I would recommend you go to the place in Skipton. I would love to see what happens.
I've got loads of hair.
But you've got loads to spare. You could donate to the women in Essex and still have hair.
Thank you.
You could create your own merkins.
They
are wigs for down below.
Yeah, I'll do that, I don't mind.
Not much call for the merkin now, is it? Went out sort of about 150 years ago.
No, you just see them on the road like masks.
And Lee's teammate, Catherine Ryan. Catherine is very upfront about the fact she's paid for plastic surgery. She's very happy to put her money where her mouth was. Lee, how do you think you're going to do tonight?
I've been on the show quite a few times now, and I've worked out that probably the most important thing is who you're with. It can be the difference between winning and losing. And tonight, I feel very, very confident, because tonight, John has got Joe. So I reckon we're in with a chance.
Oh, yeah.
You bastard.
What do you think of their weaknesses, then?
What, weirdy and beardy? I would say that John's weakness is his inability to occasionally let other people win this. He needs to learn that there's more to life than winning a countdown teapot. And I think that Joe's weakness is his weakness for roadkill and sniffing mothballs.
He's going to win.
John, what hobbies helped you through lockdown?
I got really into coffee. I don't know if you've tried it. It's like booze that you're allowed in the morning. It gives you a nice little tickle up. I have one in the morning when I get up, cafetiere, I like a long coffee. And 11, pow, a little booster, a little espresso. And I've found it's one of the things you can talk to other people about. There's communities. I signed up to an app this morning for people who are into coffee called Grindr. You sort of get messages from other people who are... I haven't checked my messages yet, but... See, there's a guy here instantly onto me. Surprised to see you on here. He thinks I'm a tea man. he says, let's go for a coffee. Then we can go back to mine and I'll jam my... Oh!
They're a friendly bunch, aren't they?
Now you know how he grinds his coffee.
Catherine, you recently celebrated your first anniversary. How is married life going? You married your childhood sweetheart, right?
Yes, I married him at the end of 2019.
And when I say your childhood sweetheart, you both knew each other at school. It's not like you're not going out with a much younger man.
I've never dated any children. I don't know. I don't really date anyone. And then I just went back to the boyfriend I had when I was 15 because I fucked everyone else.
You like, you'd like completed the set and went, oh, that first one was actually all right.
I liked him the best. Isn't that annoying? Like, what was I doing then for 20 years?
Well, we know what you were doing. You're fucking everyone else.
I'm welling up here.
Joe, if you could give people one piece of advice, what would that be?
Cool. What, from my life?
From a film?
From a film?
I've heard that question so many times in my life. Well, what would you give you one person? And no one has ever answered, what, from my life or from a film?
God, you've stumped me, Jimmy. I'd have to say never tell a bride with a bit of dog shit on her dress to chillax. They get annoyed, that's all I'm saying, they get annoyed. Especially when they find out it was you that threw it at her. We'd run out of confetti, I had to improvise. And, I'll put it down to the stress of not being invited.
OK, Lee, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, no, I've got a mascot, Jimmy. I've brought something that, in our family, is considered very lucky. This is my great-great-grandfather's pocket watch.
Wow.
And had it with him when he fought in the Boer War in the late 19th century. He was on a mission one day and he was actually shot in the chest. And guess what was in his top pocket?
Was it the pocket watch?
A packet of fags. The bullet went straight through and killed him instantly. And so, this ended up going to his brother, who then gave it down to his... And it passed down. And just a few weeks ago, it was passed on to me. But I've already got a watch. I've got one of those, you know, Fitbit ones. It's great, so I don't need this. So, I've stuck it on eBay, and it's already up to about 35 quid. So, pretty lucky, yeah?
Well,
what a long journey that, wasn't it, for the punchline? It started in the late 19th century.
I liked him getting shot.
He got shot straight through his chest. I'll think of another alternate whilst you're asking someone else, and I'll say, I've got another alternate.
So the watch was fine, that's a bit of luck.
What about this one?
He hit it up his ass.
No, that's been done before, hasn't it?
You said that like Morgan Freeman's, if that's a scene from Shawshank Redemption.
Oh, yeah.
And he crawled through 5 miles of his own shit.
Catherine, have you got a mascot?
No, I didn't bring one. I couldn't think of one, but I've just been writing poetry every day about my best friend and how much I miss him.
Who's your best friend?
Jimmy Carr.
Okay.
I miss my best friend, Jimmy Carr. I'm lost without his teaching. Like, who to see for Botox, who to avoid for anal bleaching. I miss his laugh, his private jet. I long for the hurtful barbs. I miss going to fancy restaurants and Jimmy saying I can't have carbs. I miss comforting his butlers. After their grueling triple shift. While Jimmy's hosting royalty and they're all plotting their next grift. I loved being your sidekick. And now it seems I've got the sack. He's doing great without me. Jimmy, all your hair's grown back. I'm cross with Boris and this whole COVID mess. So until this shit relaxes, you're my hero. And I hope you know, I'm glad you dodged those taxes.
John, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, sort of. I thought I'd use this opportunity to pitch some new sort of reality TV shows. And I sort of also assumed that people who watch this programme probably don't actually like new programmes. What they like is a programme they know changed a little bit, because that's what this is. So, I've got a new show where we've got cameras all around a restaurant, and what you get is a couple, it's gone really sour. Really bad, and we know that one of them is about to dump the other one. So I present Channel 4's new smash hit, Last Dates. You can watch the totting, the sighing, the moving of the food around the plate.
I know you're joking, but genuinely, that is a brilliant idea.
On the subject of reducing the sort of sexual output of this country and the happiness, every year Strictly comes around, and every year the BBC claim to be absolutely appalled by the curse of Strictly, where people have sex with each other. Not on my new show, Very Strictly Come Dancing. Where the contestants all are in different warehouses wearing boiler suits and they dance on Zoom for the amusement of Craig Revel Hallwood. Absolutely no chemistry, no sexual tension. Let's find out if you really like dancing, Britain. Of course you fucking don't. I think the problem with a lot of these celebrity talent shows is, come the end, these people are all still alive. And so you know, what has been the point of all of this? They might be on something else next year. Well, that jeopardy now has been ramped up with my new show, The Island with Bear. It's exactly like The Island with Bear Grylls, but there's just a bear there. And every now and again, someone gets mauled to death, and the prize of the winner is they get sedated before they're mauled to death. They don't feel the pain. Thanks to Fleabag, we've now got this idea in society of a sexy priest, hot priest. It's cruel on the priest because, of course, we know the priests aren't allowed to have sex with people, are they? So I've got a new talent show where the Britain's sexiest priests are sent to an island with some of Britain's most beautiful and intelligent women, and the game is they have to not have sex with any of them, and if they do, they get a life of misery selling a lie in the church. It's a new show I've got called I'm a Celibate, Get Me Out of That.
John's TV formats, everyone. Joe, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I brought along the glove compartment from a 1997 Ford Mondeo.
That's the glove compartment from a car?
Yeah.
Why?
The reason I brought it along is, you know, I live with a lot of Alsatians, and that is incredibly stressful. And I find the mechanism on the glove compartment of a 1997 Ford Mondeo very soothing, because it's a very soothing action. And it helps me unwind. Someone can say to me, oh, one of your bigger dogs has got out. I don't give a shit.
Oh, that's lovely. That's.
Yeah, I also find applying. That was heavier than I thought it would be.
Imagine if you'd brought a whole one.
Yeah. I love applying toilet duck. I find it very. Oh, that's nice. That's a little slice of heaven, that is. Oh. Imagine Richard Branson doing that, can't you, after buying an aeroplane.
I can smell that, that's absolutely toilet.
We'll have that later. but the best way that I like to relax is, I've got a friend, Chris, who doesn't mind being kicked in the plums. So I've brought him along, and Chris, do you mind coming out, mate, and just show him how? Oh, God, I feel so stressed. Go on, pop your legs apart, big guy. Oh, God, what a long day.
Sorry, what are you going to do?
I'm just going to kick him in the plums. What do you think I'm going to do? Look at this. Oh, that's good. Oh, God, I can feel it all coming off me. Oh, that's good.
You've got a lovely technique.
Really? Is anyone else want to go? Anyone in the crew is a bit pissed off with having to deal with Rachel. Yeah, go on then, have a go. Go on.
Oh, no.
Yeah, go on, give it. Oh,
Chris!
Go on, get stuck in, guys.
Oh, cute.
Absolutely, you can feel the stresses of the day. Just
this is weird even for us.
Just so worth it, isn't it?
Don't try that at home, kids.
Cheers, Chris. You can go now, mate. I'll see you. I'll pick you up in A&E. All right, cheers, mate.
Okay, over in Dictionary Corner, it's the Brett Domino Trio. Brett and Stephen are partners in crime, and that crime, I assume, is masturbating in public. The Brett Domino Hello Trio. Just goes to show, it doesn't matter how many times you do it, you won't go blind. Brett, you've performed all over the world. Do you have a favourite venue?
We played in a converted abattoir in Madrid once. That was.
Well, that nearly didn't happen though, did it? Because of you.
Yeah, that we nearly missed that one because I had surgery on my right testicle about a week beforehand. Yeah, about an hour before we went on, I noticed the stitches had come out. So I was in the hotel room trying to get through to 111. You know, the NHS direct. But if you phone 111 from Spain, you get the Spanish Traffic Authority. Mm. And it took quite a while to find someone who spoke English. And then even when I did, he didn't really know what to do. Sorry, what was the question?
Can I ask?
Wow, that is a hell of a story. Yeah, please, Joe.
Do you reckon you could recognise your balls in a lineup?
In a lineup?
I don't know if I could pick mine out. If there was, like, 20 photos of balls.
I said the nearest ones to me are mine.
Yeah. Not always the case as you get older. You sort of lob them
That's
over there.
That's true.
And with the Brett Domino Trio, of course, it's Susie Dent. unbelievably, Susie Dent has a new book out. I don't know where you get your ideas from, Susie, but I wish you'd stop going there. Susie, you often tweet a word of the day. What's today's offering?
Oh, well, I knew I was going to see you, Jimmy. Stiff rump.
What, sorry?
Stiff rump.
Stiff rump.
Yes, and a stiff rump is a 17th century word for someone who refuses to change their opinion. Like, you've been a stiff rump with me for years.
I have changed my mind about you. I used to think you wrote boring books, and now I think you're also sexually very promiscuous.
Yeah, and still write boring books.
I love that, Susie. Stiff rump.
Stiff rump,
I can use that as a double entendre in one of my next poems.
Excellent.
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. How did you keep yourself busy during lockdown, Rachel?
Well, we had the baby during lockdown, so we'd go to the park every day because nothing else was open. You know, feed the ducks and pick up Russian girls.
And pick up Russian girls?
Yeah. Because obviously I want her to be bilingual. And it's cheaper than, you know, getting a teacher. You just go to the park, pick up Russian girls.
What park are you going to? OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Condiments.
Lovely.
Just put a bit of mustard on it. Well, take a bite of it. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for our first game. John, Joe, you get the first pick of the letters.
May I have a con...
you may,
please.
Thank you,
Joe. T. Vowel, please.
E.
E. Consonant, please.
D.
Yes. I try and spell out a word in the order, otherwise I'm buggered. Consonant, please.
You got four.
Oh, yes!
Flying.
Still in it, still in it. Vowel, please.
I.
Consonant, please.
W.
Consonant, please.
G.
Shit! And then just a really good vowel, please.
U.
Consonant, maybe an N. Ooh, oh, that was even better! Hot shit!
And for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. Can you unplug it, please? Oh, thanks, mate. Yeah, I think what's happened is I've it's sucked too hard. John, how many?
Well, I'll try an 8.
Lee, how many?
6.
All right, Joe, how many?
I've got 7, but I don't know if it's right.
Catherine?
I have 7.
Fabio, could you put it on blow and I'll see if I can get out? Ah, there you go.
Yeah, I had it on. It was too powerful.
Catherine, what's your word?
Twisted.
Twisted?
That's really good.
Lee, what's your 6?
Detest.
Ooh.
Basically, we're just looking at you, Jimmy, and thinking of the first thing that comes to mind, aren't we? Twisted. Detest.
Joe?
Witters.
Brilliant word.
It is, isn't
wow!
it?
Wow! That's really, really good.
John, what's your eight?
Turdiest.
Oh, God.
Turdiest. Susie Dent, what are you going to spoil this for him, are you?
I have to spoil Lee's as well, because there's no two E's for detest. Not sure how you were spelling it. But turdy is not in the dictionary, therefore you cannot have turdy.
So we have to use mine.
7 points to both James. Joe Wilkinson actually helping. Brett Domino Trio, Susie Dent, could they have done any better?
Yes, detritus was there for eight.
OK, on to our first numbers round. Lee, Catherine, your turn to pick the numbers.
What are you meant to pick? Two big ones.
Candy.
Please, Rachel.
And four little.
Don't look at me for what... You mean what? Whether big or little?
Yeah.
What's the rules?
Two big ones.
Is there only big and little?
Yeah.
And what's the definition of little? Is a 10 a little?
Yeah, 10's a
little. But everything above a 10 is a big?
Yeah.
It's been a while since I've been on, and even longer since I've watched it. we'll have two big ones and the rest small ones.
So seven.
Thank you.
One.
Yeah.
Three.
Yeah.
Five. 75. And 100.
Yes, it's 100.
I like the 100.
And that's bollocks.
Yes! Press it. No, don't
press it again, please. Press it again, press it again.
No, no, please!
Oh, we all do that one.
Oh, yeah, that's fine.
You don't do this. You don't do this on the other one.
Yeah.
Oh, that seems better. Okay, your time starts now.
Right.
The target is 534.
Right. Don't talk.
7135. 75100. The numbers again. 7135.
Oh, you're making me
stop. Shut your face.
7135.
Oh, right. 75, stop, please.
What?
I'm gonna break down.
7135.
I can't
do math.
I can't do it if you say the number. Now I'm bollocking out of time, aren't I?
Have you got it?
Oh, yeah. I think
you've got it?
No.
Okay, John, did you get it?
Yes.
Joe, did you get it?
Yeah.
Joe.
Okay, so, Rachel, yeah. Work with me.
Yeah.
Five times.
Five times.
No, sorry, 100 plus. Seven.
107.
Times five.
535.
535 minus the one.
Yay,
made up on the spot.
Three,
didn't even need to write it down. Just did it.
Joe Wilkinson is having his best ever game.
That's two from two.
Wow!
Two
from two.
Lee, did you do it the same way?
Yeah, I did it the same way.
Okay. Catherine, did you get it?
No, I absolutely didn't get it. I don't think of things like this. Adding before the multiplication, and I'll take that skill with me into
John
the future.
John taught me that. That's one of the many things John taught me. Also kissing on the neck. work up to the ear and then across.
OK, so 10 points to Joe.
I did it the same as him.
You did it the same way...
as him?
Yeah, did you?
Yes.
Yeah. Do you want the evidence? All up here, mate.
Slide the paper across.
Yeah, let's do it like proper countdown. Just slide the paper across.
I told you it's all up here. Don't just, slide me across.
All right, okay, we'll give you the benefit of the doubt.
Well,
10
well.
Points to both teams.
Oh, all right.
Just about to cave.
All right. 10 points to both teams.
Yeah.
Wow. This is horseshit.
What's happening?
The scores at the moment, both teams have 17 points. And here is your teaser. The words are nippy gal. The clue is put some cream on it. That's nippy gal. Put some cream on it. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were nippy gal. The clue was put some cream on it. It was, of course, applying. So, both teams have 17 points. Lee and Catherine, your turn to choose the letters.
A consonant.
P.
And a vowel.
E.
Consonant, please.
R.
A consonant, please.
Yep. N.
Vowel, please.
O.
Perno. consonant.
M.
Vowel.
You.
and a consonant.
R.
Another consonant.
And the last one, D.
OK, so your time starts now. Right. Oh, there's lovely. God damn it, I landed on my testicles. That's too hot. Catherine, how many?
7.
Okay. Lee, how many?
7.
Okay. John, I can't stay in this position much longer. How many have you got?
7.
Oh, God. I genuinely think I might have split one. Joe, how many?
I've got 6.
Well, I'll be one second. Oh, God, my balls. Oh, I made s'mores for everyone on the campfire. So a little sugar rush for you.
What's a s'more?
Marshmallow, biscuit and chocolate. I'd strongly recommend.
Oh my gosh.
Is it nice?
Mmm.
I'm not going to end up waking up in your cellar again, am I, Jimmy? That is really nice.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
It's just a shame it's going to come out the other end. Always disappoints me when I'm eating something. I think, in a few hours, that'll be in the loo.
Have you ever considered writing restaurant reviews? I mean, it was all right and everything, but it's going to be shit soon enough.
What you want to do is do what I do. Mix it up a bit by shoving it up your arse and puking it out.
Been there, done it.
That can happen if you get ill enough, you can vomit feces.
Thanks, Jim. I'm really enjoying this.
Yeah, pretty good.
How's the after dinner speaking going? All right.
Catherine, are you eating carbs?
Well, I found out this whole time I've been celiac.
You've been a celiac?
The whole time. And I just thought I hated bread.
What was the effect? What did it cause?
Nothing.
You're a celiac and there was no negative effects. Yeah. I'm not a doctor, but I don't think you're a celiac.
I really am. I'll show you the paperwork.
Joe, what's your 6?
Murder.
John, your 7?
Pounder.
Pounder. Susie?
Very good.
Lee, your 7?
Mourner.
Catherine, your 7?
Mine is mourned.
OK, 7 points to each team.
Yes, well done.
So what are these things called that you're eating now? Because the kids will want this when I go.
S'mores.
You almost sounded like a really good dad the way you said it, but there was such anger when you went, so how do you make those? Because the kids will want them. There was such fury in it.
Well, I only get to see them every other Friday. I want it to go well.
Right, Domino Trio, Susie Dent, did you think they could do any better?
I think 7 was the best. Prouder was
Sorry,
the
did end you end. Think 7 was the best? Or were you just eating a biscuit and you couldn't be bothered to look? OK, so at the end of that, both teams have 24 points.
Yes.
Neck and neck.
Wow.
Right, John, Joe, your turn to pick the numbers.
Now, it's controversial. I only like one big one or no big ones. I don't like two big ones.
I'll follow you to the end of the earth, John.
We just have the one big one.
You've got 2.
Yes.
4.
Fucking
3. 1.
Oh, my God.
They're quite
Number
small,
one,
to
they're
be
quite
fair. They're
small.
They're quite
We're
small.
In the danger
I mean, it's the smallest we've ever seen.
560.
Okay, and your time starts now. So the target was 560. Did you get it? Joe Wilkinson?
Yeah.
John, did you get it?
No.
Lee?
Yeah, 560, yeah.
OK, and Catherine?
No.
Lee?
I'm just drinking. Joe, take it from me.
No, please, you.
No, come on, it's your lucky day.
I need a shit.
Right. I've got the 25.
Yeah.
And the 1 and the 1 and the 3 and the 4 and the 2. And then I did exactly what Joe did. 36 I got.
You got 36.
Do you want me to show you how to do it? 25 plus 1 plus 1 plus 3 plus 4 plus 2 plus 36. Now, you're laughing, but if Joe hasn't got it, that's closer, isn't it?
Joe, how did you do it? I mean, if you can pull this out of the bag on the fly... Rachel, can it be done?
Well, I've got one away. With two ones, it's one of the tricky ones. There's lots of targets that are just impossible.
OK, so this is really a Hail Mary shot here.
This could go viral. Right, one plus 25.
26.
Times 4.
Times 4, 104.
OK. What's left?
You've got 3, a 1 and a 2.
3, a 1 and a 2, that's perfect. 3... Yeah, add those together.
3, 1 and 2?
Yeah, 3, 1 and 2 is 6.
Yeah.
Times it by... add those together?
624.
Fuck. I'd be honest with you, I'm annoyed at myself.
Rachel, how did you get one away?
25 times 2 is 50. Add 1 for 51.
Oh, yeah.
3 times 4 is 12, minus the other one is 11, and times those together for 5, 6, 1. One away.
Well done. OK, so both teams have 24 points. OK, time now to go across to Dictionary Corner, the Brett Domino Trio. What have you got for us?
Well, I don't know if you're familiar with this piece of history, but in 1970, a big dead whale washed up on the coast of Oregon in America. Too big to do anything with, they didn't really know how to deal with it. So they decided to blow it up with dynamite. But they used a bit too much dynamite, they misjudged the amount they were going to use. When they exploded it, it basically rained down big chunks of whale blubber for miles around.
Bits of it went in the car park.
Huh?
Bits of him went in the car park, apparently. crushed cars. And stuff.
Yeah. He doesn't say much, but when he does.
So I've written. I'm in the process of adapting this true story into a West End musical. So I'd quite like to perform a song from that. Now, this song is from the perspective of a guy called George Thornton, who was the guy who was put in charge of trying to get rid of the whale. Okay. Well, as bad days go, this is off the scale. What am I supposed to do with the 45-foot whale? I tried to push it, but it won't shift. It's starting to rock, and it really stinks. It's a major operation, disposing of the deceased cetacean. Cetacean is another word for whale. But hold on, what's this thought lurking at the back of my mind? Dynamite. I solved my problem with dynamite. I'll blow the whale up into tiny little pieces, a little treat for all the seagulls. It's dynamite, solving my problems with dynamite. Oh, nothing can go wrong. I'm just strapping a whale to a half-ton bomb. It would be like Christmas Day, raining beautiful snowflakes of the decomposing carcass of a dead sperm whale. And every year we'll celebrate this day and the great decision that I made by finding and exploding another massive dead whale.
The Brett Domino Trio, everyone.
I love information communicated via West End Musical.
Mm.
I wish I got all my news that way.
Fingers crossed Andrew Lloyd Webber was watching.
No, because then he'd insist on writing it, wouldn't he?
I mean, I thought the West End was in trouble before you summoned it. The scores at the moment, both teams have 24 points. And here is your teaser. The words are shite tip. The clue is the shorter the better. That shite tip, the shorter the better. See you after the break. Well, Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were shite tip. The clue was the shorter the better. It was, of course, pithiest. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Joe and Catherine. Huh? And we're going to mix things up a little bit. Let's play Count Upside Down. Mm. Joe, do you spend a lot of your time upside down?
Not really, only when I sleep.
OK, underneath your chairs, there is a box with special goggles that make everything look upside down.
Yeah.
Pop those on and then make your way to the podium. For viewers at home, we're just going to change the screen now to what they'll see when they put the goggles on. This is what they see with the upside-down goggles on. It's pretty disconcerting.
It's all gone upside down.
Yeah, they do make things go upside down. That's why it's called Count Upside Down.
Oh, bollocks to this.
Nick, you want us to walk around here?
Yes.
Yeah.
Catherine, come around this way.
No, I don't want to get hit.
I feel like we can't do this.
Okay, so... All right, Catherine has opted for the walking most of the way.
You can't do that. I'll die.
Where's this movement? Who's that?
We can't see.
Well, you can see, but it's just upside down.
Joe, you're moving like there are things in real life that you can't see.
Joe, you're this side.
I wish I hadn't done ecstasy. Oh, I see. If you look up, it goes down.
Over here, Joe.
Oh, yeah. I heard you. I hear you there. Ah, here we go. There's something here. Okay, ready?
Grab a pen. Here's the rules of the game. It will only count if you write it down.
Am I in front of it?
Yes, you're in front of it. That's it, you're in exactly the right place. Catherine, move across. Before you choose your letters, Rachel, would you put on your upside-down goggles as well?
Okay.
Can I ask you a question, Jimmy?
Yeah.
But... Where did you buy these and what are they for?
I guess it's for Australians when they come here. Okay, so, Joe, pick the letters.
Can I have a consonant, please? Where is the thing that Rachel... Where's Rachel? I can't see the... Where's the...
Rachel will say them out loud if she can read them.
N.
Oh, no, it goes the other way if you write it.
Oh, no!
Consonant, please. Oh, I can see you.
G.
G.
Hang on.
Right. I don't care. Just give me something like an I. Draw that.
A.
Consonant, please.
A.
Consonant, please.
Okay. It's an L.
L.
Vowel, please.
Oh. I.
Consonant, please. Oh.
T.
It's T. This is insanity. I hate my life. Vowel.
That is near enough.
E, I think.
E, yeah, it's an E, yeah. Higher, higher, Rachel. Higher. Higher. Not lower, higher.
Consonant.
So that was a T, E.
Oh.
OK. And your time starts...
What?
Now.
You're flipping,
Jim. Only counts if it's written down. Okay, Catherine, how many?
Seven.
Seven, okay. And Joe, how many?
Four.
Four?
Yes!
Okay, take your goggles off. Joe, what's your word?
Pint.
Pint is a word, and four's pretty good for you. Well done, Joe. Huge. Catherine, what is your seven?
I had pelting or peeling.
Very good.
Pelting or peeling? Both very good.
What?
7 points to Catherine. OK, time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. The Brett Domino Trio, what have you got for us?
We've got a song for you, Jimmy. I've been spending quite a lot of time in outdoor pursuit superstores of late. Just like the vibe. So I'm going to do a song based on my experience there. It's called I Think I'm In Love With The Girl Who Works On Checkout 6 In Decathlon. I only went in to get Wellington boots. A friend of mine
insisted on going camping in the Lake District for his stag do. Never really been the type of guy to kill time in a sports retailer. Saw the World Cup final and I played a bit of netball as a teenager. All the ski boots, bikes and bells got me feeling a bit out of my depth. And I saw you when you took away my breath. Well, this feeling's new to me. Never thought I'd be so enamored with a store employee, so outdoorsy. But this is more than a crush now. I think I'm in love with the girl who works on checkout six in Decathlon. Haven't known her that long, but all I hear is birdsong when I see that girl on checkout six in Decathlon. Yes, I've fallen headlong. Chemistry we had none, but it's early days. We only met for 40 seconds. You complimented me on my unusually small feet. When our fingers touched very briefly as you handed me the receipt, you can't deny the electricity. Yeah, I know we've probably got nothing in common. Yeah, you clearly like the great outdoors. And I'm allergic to pollen. So we don't share the same aesthetic. Maybe you're looking for a boy who's unathletic. You can teach me how to canoe. My girl will check out six in Decathlon.
The Fred Domino Trio. So at the end of that, Lee and Catherine are in the lead with 31 points. Come on! And here is your final teaser. The words are erect sex. The clue is it's seeping out. That's erect sex. It's seeping out. See you after the break. Of the teaser, the words were erect sex. The clue was it's seeping out. It was, of course, excretes. Okay, time for our final letters game. Lee, Catherine, your turn to choose. Come on, Catherine.
Could we please have a consonant, Rachel?
Thank you, Catherine. S.
A vowel.
A.
Two more consonants, please.
H. M.
A vowel, please.
I.
Another vowel, please.
A.
What do you think? The rest consonants?
I think probably.
Yeah, why not?
An R. An L.
And then maybe a vowel.
Shall I let you choose? If you want an I or an M?
Nice dumb down for the celebrity version, isn't it?
Celebrity, get over yourself. It's just the late night version.
What's better?
Let's chuck an N up.
Your 30 seconds starts now. Pleased with that. I built a bookcase. John, how many?
Seven.
I think it's probably faulty, yeah.
Wow.
Lee, how many?
Seven.
Joe?
Just realised my seven's missing a letter.
My seven's missing a letter?
That'd be a six, then.
Yeah, six.
Six, OK. And Catherine?
I only have six.
You only have six. OK, what's your six?
Relish.
And, of course, the countdown condiments are what's on the line this evening, so...
I want those.
Very apposite. Yeah, you're thinking about the prize.
Yeah.
Joe, what is your six?
Loners.
Except there's no O.
Yeah, I realised there wasn't an O, and I still said it.
John, you're seven?
Manlier.
Mmm, very good.
Lee?
I was eating some mashed potato the other day, and my mashed potato was very mashy. There's no way you could get mashed potato that was more mashy than my mashed potato. The person next to me says, you're wrong, because mine's mashier. Mm. I said, I remember that, it might crop up. I said, what do you do? He said, I work for the Oxford Society. Interesting.
Right.
She says, yeah, we don't put all the words in. Susie Dent sometimes gets it wrong.
Is mashier in there, Susie Dent?
No.
Oh, okay. You can't. Well, surely you can be mashier. Something gets mashed, but something gets more mashed. It's mashier.
Yeah.
Seriously, doesn't it? Don't put your tongue back in your mouth. You don't.
Never trust a woman who's reading the dictionary with a tonga.
7 points to John.
Thank you.
And lest we forget, Joe. The Brett Domino Trio, Susie, could they have done any better?
They could have had inhaler.
Ah, inhalers.
Inhalers.
OK, so both teams have 31 points. It's fingers on buzzers. Time for today's crucial countdown conundrum.
Good luck, John.
Your time starts now.
Come on, John.
John?
Breathiest.
No, keep going.
Batteries?
No, you're right!
Is the right answer. Lee and Catherine have done it with 41 points. They are tonight's winners and the proud owners of the Countdown Condiments. Thanks to all our panellists and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Make me laugh. Ah, go on. Celebs doing actual stand-up for cancer. Badil's one of the coaches and Jason Manford next Thursday at 9. Tonight and next on More 4, Jonathan Rhys-Meyers, blockbustery and epic, The Tudors. But coming next, comedy with Back.